Hello and welcome to the next phase. So in this phase we will be talking about how much of the irises you're supposed to show if you have a specific expression, or in this case a smile, and also I'll talk about what the smile does to the cheeks and how a person smiles mostly with the cheeks and the eyes and not just the mouth. So you see, here I'm still adding some shading to define the nose, and you've usually noticed that if you put a lot of value around the corners of the eyes, it really makes the face look more tri-dimensional and makes the expression look much livelier. So here you can see that the eyes really determine the expression, and in this case we have this satisfied expression, a sincere smile. So in fact what it does is that the smile brings up the cheeks, pushes the cheeks up, and the cheeks push up the lower eyelids. So if you have an expression like this, you will notice that the white part of the eyes is not going to show either below or above the irises, and not even the entire irises are going to show, because we see the lower eyelids being pushed up. So if we want to convey a smile, it is something that you need to pay specific attention to. And when it comes to the iris, I usually do this part at the very end, as I said, but to get the expression right, I work a lot on the eyelids. I'm really not happy with the eyes right now, so this is something that I will be perfecting in the later phases. Again, you can see that there is a very strong line defining the bottom of her upper eyelid, and that it also throws a shade on her iris. It's important to notice that. So just like the upper lip throws a shadow over the teeth, and it's important to emphasize that line, it is also important to emphasize the lower edge of the upper eyelid and the way that it is throwing a shadow above the eyes and specifically on the iris. So a bit more value in the corner of the eyes. And this is something to experiment on. You can always delete or get rid of the excess value, but in this case I would recommend quite a lot of value added around the eyes, because it really does bring up the expression, and the expression comes from the eyes mostly. So, again, a bit more shadowing to define the nose, and now we will work specifically on the smile. But you can see that my pencil simply cannot rest on one single feature. If you want the smile to be genuine, we want to emphasize the lines created by the smile, and also add some value between the nose and the upper lip, because we want to emphasize that that is now on a plane that is further away from us as the viewer than the cheeks, because the cheeks are pushed forwards also by the smile, so forwards and upwards. And these lines here are created by this smile, so I'm going to emphasize them. Again, I will add some value here around the corners of the mouth to emphasize how the cheeks are pushed forward and upward, and this groove just below the lower lip needs to be emphasized as well, because we want the chin also to come out tridimensionally. Again, what I usually say about the corners of the mouth to make the smile look more genuine. You want a lot of value in the corners of the mouth because they are in the dark inside the mouth, and you want this little downturn in the corners of the mouth to make it look warm and genuine. So a bit more shading on the lower lip, and you can notice that it is coming out relatively well. So here I'm defining her chin. A chin is also very important. I've noticed that when it comes to resemblance, the shape of the face overall, and especially the chin, really create the likeness here. So there is a lot of value in this part, as you can see, and I'm adding quite a lot of shading here, and I've heard some people say that too much shading will age your drawing and that the person will look too old, but then in my experience I haven't noticed that it is true. In fact, if it were, then how would we even draw people who are in a shadow, or there, for example, a person like this who has a shadow falling over one half of their face. So in fact, it's not the shading that ages a person, it is in fact more in the proportion of the proportions of the face, the size of the features. As I've mentioned, it is about the size of the eyes, and especially the size of the irises compared to the eyes overall. Or it is individual, I mean, it depends on the person, but for the most part, those are the most telltale signs of age. And of course, as I said, we need to differentiate between the lines that we are going to emphasize on the drawing. We do not want to emphasize wrinkles, but rather those lines that are created by her expression. So, see you in the next one.